guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Rinki and today I bring to you a few easy tips and tricks how to look good on a video call. Now we all know that because of this pandemic, we are all forced to work from home or stay connected with our loved ones through a video call. So it is very easy and necessary to be looking proper in this video call. So let's straightly dive into the tips. So the very important trick to have a great video call is proper lighting. So when we talk about lighting, natural lighting is the best way to get when you are on a video call. So if you are getting a FaceTime call from the crush that you have, or if you are taking a professional call over the platform for an office meeting, it is always better that you have a setup wherein you know that you have natural lighting coming on. Now, I know that maybe in the evening or at night, you may not have the proper daylight or the natural lighting. What you can do is, in that case, you can always use a ring light, which I am using. I will definitely list down the product details in my description below. Or you could also invest on a selfie light. These are very inexpensive and easy ways to have a great video call with a very little expense or investment. So go for it. Tip would be the proper angle. Now I cannot stress enough the importance of having the proper angle while taking a video call. At times you may take the video call a little below your eye level, or at times you may also take from above, but it is not very flattering to do that because you may end up showing or exposing a lot of your unflattering features of your face. So because at times you may show up your double chin if you're taking it from a lower angle, or at times you may also show up from above, and that will give a lot of shadow on your face, which is not very flattering obviously. So angle is definitely very, very important. So the right way or the right level of angle while taking a video call would be at your eye level, so that you have an eye-to-eye contact to the person that you are conversation with. Another very important thing is what to wear. I know that because we are all working from home or stuck to our home, we are mostly in our tank tops or probably a pajama set, right? So the easiest way to actually look put together is to throw a blazer if you have or even a shrug, just to look that you are put together and ready for the call. So that is the easiest way. So try to go for solid colors because it is not very distracting. Now if you're wearing too much of pattern or floral colors, it may get a little distracting for the person who you are in conversation with. So try and choose solid colors that gives you a proper professional feeling altogether in the entire video conversation. Also, if you have a pair of glasses, it'll always look a notch higher professional if you throw them into you right away. So that gives a very professional, geeky or a nerdy look instantly without even putting any effort. That might be powered or no, zero powered as per your preference. So go for it. So I would also want to focus upon the makeup and the hairstyle. So now we know that in every video call we are mostly exposing our body top portion, right above your navel. So the best part is you do not have to really get dressy or go all out when it comes to hair and makeup. You could stick to something like a multi-using makeup trick, like a cheek and lip stain or a lip balm that instantly boost up your appearance. So it gives you a more refreshed look and very put together. And even for the hair, I would suggest, anyhow nobody sees your backside, so maybe you could just straighten a little bit on the front, or curl or make some waves in the front, whichever is your style statement. So it looks very, very put together, and as I said, you need not have to go all out and look glamorous, but you just need to look put together. So a little bit of makeup and a hairdo would never harm anybody and would make you look very, very put together. Another very common mistake that we all do, I have done it myself, is look at them and not to yourself. I know it could be very tempting when you could see yourself on the screen. You often tend to get tempted to look at yourself but not them. So it is very awkward on the other person who is on the call to see that angle of you. It shows that you're not really interested in the conversation, or rather, you know, you're getting distracted by looking at yourself. So try and focus to the fact that you need to look exactly through the camera lenses. That would give you a eye-to-eye contact with the person that you are talking. Another very important tip that we often tend to forget is to keep your phone or tablet on silent mode or DND mode, because at times, let's say you are taking an interview over a video call and you have your phone ringing or buzzing in between. That is very distracting, and it may also distract the entire direction of your conversation you are having in the video call. So try and keep your phone and your tablets or your devices on DND mode if possible. Another tip would be a little mindful about your background. So when I say background, as you can see in my background, I do not have too flashy colors or too much of distraction or too much of movement happening. So this definitely does not distract the opposite person who is on the other side of the call. So if you have, imagine you have a backdrop wherein water is boiling, or you know, your pet is just walking by. I know that is quite common, but it does not really give a very good impression, especially if it is a professional call. So try and set up a corner wherein you have a silent space or a not very distracting backdrop while taking the video call. This would go a long way. A very important pro tip would be to do a test call. So even if that could be an interview, or so if you have a big interview coming on a video platform, it is always good that you test the platform by doing a test call either with the recruiter or with your friends and family. Maybe just give a call to your mother and test the quality of the call. This gives you more preparedness as to when you take the real call. So always go for a test call. So that will be all for today, and I hope that we all get out of this pandemic real soon and we get back to our normal lives very soon. And until then, let's all pray that we get out sooner, all healthier and happier. Take care and stay happy. Bye-bye.